The French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Stores.
Here is our dear little old friend, the chicken. Today we are just interested in the breast. We're going to bone it and skin it and serve it as a very tasty morsel, a suprême de volaille. Today on the French Chef. Welcome to the French Chef. I'm Julia Child. Today we are going to do breast of chicken in the French manner, which means it's a peel, it's a skinless, boneless, luscious, delicate morsel of white meat which cooks in about 6 to 8 minutes and makes a perfectly elegant, quick meal. And with it we're going to serve risotto or braised rice. And as that cooks fairly quickly, I'm going to start that first, and then we'll get back to our chicken. Now, risotto is, of course, of Italian origin in name, but this is the way the French cook braised rice, and they call it risotto, and whenever they take over a recipe, they do it in their own way, and they don't care how anyone else does it. And this, you use a long grain rice, and when you buy rice, you just look on the box or the package, and it always says long grain or fancy long grain. And it's perfectly plain, ordinary, raw, white rice. I think a lot of people are afraid to cook rice because it gets sort of gummy, and that's mainly that nobody's told them some of the basic principles of how to cook it. And in risotto, the rice is cooked for a little while in butter and then simmered in seasoned liquids. So we're going to start it out right now. And we're going to cook it on top of the stove. And we're going to put in about a tablespoon and a half of butter. And then for flavoring, 2 tablespoons of finely minced onion. And that's going to cook slowly until the onion is translucent. And then the rice is going to go in. Now, in this method of cooking rice, you want to make very sure that your measurements are correct. And everybody knows about these dry measure cups. You have a 1 cup and a half cup and a third and a fourth. And when the cup is full up to the top, that means it's a full cup. And for this kind of a dish, you want to measure very carefully because it's important how much liquid you use. We're going to use 1 1/4 cups of rice. And 1 full cup of raw rice will cook up into 3 cups of cooked rice. And that's about enough for 4 people, which we're serving. But I'm going to add a little bit more because it's so good. So we're going to use 1 1/4 cups. And now you cook your onions until they're fairly tender. They're going to get cooking later. And then you pour in your rice. This is plain, unwashed rice because you want it to be perfectly dry. And the reason that you're going to cook it in the butter is to cook the floury coating on the rice, because it's that floury coating, which you don't deal with it in some way, which becomes gooey. And in the braised rice, the cooking of it is what prevents it from becoming gummy after it's cooked. And when the rice first goes in, it has a milky look, and then as soon as it gets turned in the butter, the rice looks translucent. And you want to cook it slowly until the grains have become milky again. And that takes about 2 or 3 minutes over moderate heat. And the rice is not supposed to brown, it just stays a white, it'll be a white milky color by the time it's done. And while that's cooking, we have our liquid, and you use whatever liquid you would be using for your main course. In this case, we're using chicken, so this is canned chicken broth and water. I'm using about half and half. And in this, the proportions are very important. You have, if you have 1 cup of rice, you use 2 cups of liquid. So in this case, we have 1 1/4 cups of rice. So we're using 2 1/2 cups of liquid. And pour it into a liquid measure. And then you want to make sure that it's absolutely accurate. So set it on a flat place. And then get your eye right down to that mark, which is 2 1/2 there. And then you know that you have the correct amount. And then you keep looking at your rice for a minute until it turns that milky color, which it hasn't quite. So we'll finish the rest of our flavorings. We're going to use parsley and a bay leaf and tie them together. This is almost an herb bouquet. If you had a complete herb bouquet, you'd have thyme, which you could use too. And then you turn the parsley around the bay leaf and then just tie it with white string. You use white string because it doesn't have any flavor in the cooking. If you use brown or black string, maybe you'd get brown or black rice. So now we look again at our rice. And those grains have practically become milky. This is the only part in the cooking that you have to watch fairly carefully. Because once you've gotten this rice, this flour coating cooked, then you're not going to have any trouble with the rice grains sticking together. Now, there, that's cooked sufficiently. And you can very easily see this yourself when you're doing it. You'll notice that milky color. Then in goes our liquid. And we just put our herb bouquet right in. And we want this to come up to the boil. And as soon as it's come up to the boil, we then cover it and let it simmer slowly. And at this point, it's a good idea to taste it. The chicken stock already has a little bit of salt in it, but you want to have it just salty enough. Yes, that can use just a little bit more salt. And you can put in some pepper. And if you want other flavoring, say if you were having rice with fish, you could use a fish stock. If you didn't have a homemade stock, you could use clam juice and water. Or you could put a little bit of white wine in if you like. Or if you wanted, you could use tomato juice. And if you like garlic, at this point you could just squeeze a clove of garlic in, which is very nice. And then as soon as that comes up to the simmer, which it almost has, you cover it. You can stir it at this point now, but once it started to simmer and you cover it, you don't stir it at all until the rice is done, and it's going to take 18 minutes. Now it's just coming up to the boil there, and I'm going to set my timer for 18 minutes. And this is to cook at a sort of slow boil or fast simmer because all the liquid is to be absorbed by the time the rice is done. And now, back to our chicken. And we're going, because these take such a short amount of time to cook, I have some already ready-made ones which I'm going to cook right away, and then I'll go back and show you how we bone them. Now this is what the bone breast looks like. It just looks like a little lovely little piece of meat like that. And in good French cooking, a suprême de volaille, suprême or supreme means the daintiest and loveliest part of the chicken, is never boiled or poached. It's always cooked in butter in a covered casserole, or else it is sautéed. And you can put whatever flavorings you like in it, such as mushrooms, but we've used so many mushrooms, I thought we'd use something else. In this case, we're going to use vegetables. We're going to use celery and carrots and 1 or 2 mushrooms and onion, and it's all chopped up very fine. And I'll show you how you chop up things quickly and into a dice. Now here's your carrot. You see, if you tried to cut it into dice this way, it rolls around. So you take your knife and cut a sliver off the side of it like that, and then the carrot will sit perfectly nicely on the board, and then you cut long pieces like that. all the way down. And that makes you see long pieces like that. And then you take the individual pieces and cut them into strips. These are called julienne. And then you gather the strips together and cut them into dice like that. And I have some that has been already made. And you first heat the butter in your casserole. We're going to use about 3 tablespoons of butter. And then we're going to put in about a cup of this vegetable mixture. And that should cook slowly until the vegetables are tender, about 3 or 4 minutes. And then when the vegetables are tender and the butter is thoroughly bubbling in the casserole, you put your chicken breasts in. Now these have been already prepared, and they have salt and pepper and lemon juice on them. These cook in about 5 or 6 minutes, and that's why it makes such a lovely little meal. And then as soon as your butter is good and hot and bubbling and the vegetables have been cooked, you simply take your chicken breasts and lay them in and then roll them around to get them thoroughly covered with the butter and the vegetables. And as they slowly cook, they're going to cook fast, excuse me, they absorb all this delicious flavor. You just have to get them thoroughly covered there. And then you put on some wax paper, because we don't want them to brown. These are called poche à blanc, or unbrown. You cover that with your wax paper, and then you put on the cover, and it goes into the oven. And this is going to go into a 400-degree oven, and they're going to cook 5 to 6 minutes. It's amazing that they do cook so fast. And now we'll get back to how to arrive at these lovely, delicate little morsels. Now this comes, here's your breast here. I'll remove that part of that leg so you can see it better. It's all this part in here. And when you buy the chicken breast in a market, it is either a single-breasted piece like this, or you get the double breast. And sometimes it has the wing on and sometimes not, but it usually always has the bones in. You can ask your butcher to do it, or you can very easily do it yourself. I recommend you learn how to work with meat yourself, because you get a much better idea of what the meat is like. And then to bone it, you simply take a sharp knife, and there's your breastbone there, and these are the ribs here. You start at the ridge of the breastbone and just cut right down. And remember always, when you're boning something, you cut always against the bone, not against the flesh. And it's sort of a cut and scrape business. You see, there's your breastbone showing itself perfectly well. And then you just cut and sort of scrape down with your fingers. And then in the case you still have the wing left on, when you get to where the wing joins the shoulder up here, you just cut through the ball joint that attaches it. See, this is one reason why it's good to do the boning yourself. When you start to carve, you're a much better carver, because you know where everything is. And then there's your carcass. See, that's the edge of the breastbone there, and there are the ribs. And then you have your wing, which is still attached. So you just cut right down through that. Be sure that you have a sharp knife. There's a little bit of the breastbone attached there, so you'll just take that off. Then you have your skin, and that comes off very easily. You just peel it. You see, it just comes right off. And if it sticks a little bit, you use your knife. You can peel a whole chicken just doing this. And then you can save all of that skin as well to make a chicken stock out of. Now, you have your breast meat there, and you'll notice that there are two layers of it. You see, there's this inner layer, and that's the layer that was connected to the bones, and that in French is called the filet mignon. And then you have this larger piece, which is the outside, and that's called the filet. And in the filet mignon, or the little piece, you will notice a little white tendon there, and that part was attached to the wishbone, and it's tough, and that you've got to get out, because otherwise it makes the breast curl up. So you just take your knife and cut along the side of it, and then when you get the end there, you grip it with a towel or a paper towel or anything, because it's sort of slippery. You have to get a good grip on it, and then cut down the side a little bit more with your knife. You can see how it comes out there, and then you've gotten rid of it. You see it there? And then you can, if you'd like, you can take off this filet mignon part and use it as a second serving, or you can leave it on. It depends. Of course, it'll cook quicker if you've taken the filet mignon off. And then you trim the breast a little bit to get off any rough edges, like that. And then you take a big knife and you just flatten it a little bit. And then you can get these ready the day ahead of time and then wrap them in wax paper and they're ready to cook, just as we saw at the beginning. And now our chicken breast ought to be ready, so I'm going to take a look in the oven. It's been just about 5 minutes. Remember, that oven was at 400. It always smells so good. Now, you can tell when they're ready by poking them with your finger. And if it's resilient, they're done. If it's still squashy, like the raw breast, it isn't done. And if it's hard, it's overdone, which is too bad. But you want to get them just at the point when they're resilient. And this finger test is something that is very useful to know, because you can tell when steak is done by pushing it that way. Remember what the raw stuff tastes like, and remember what an overdone taste feels like, but just get used to using your finger for all sorts of things. And now at this point, our rice should be done. At least we'll take a look at it. No, that isn't done yet. You see, the liquid is still there. So we're going to make our sauce. And I'm going to take the breasts out, and then we'll make the sauce for our chicken breasts. I'll get a bigger spoon, and we'll just put these on a plate. And then all of these vegetables we keep and they go into the sauce. I mean, they stay there and we make the sauce out of it. And as you're going to see, this is a very quickly made sauce. We're going to deglaze it using a little port wine. You don't have to use wine if you don't like. But I'm going to put in about a quarter of a cup of port wine there. And then for a little more added flavor, I'm going to use some brown chicken stock. Or you can use canned beef bouillon. And I'm going to put in about a quarter of a cup there. And then that's to boil down very quickly. And then you can add cream if you'd like, or you don't have to, but I think I'm going to go the whole hog on this so that we will have some cream, and that is thickened with cornstarch. And we're going to have, let's see, we have 5 breasts here, and so we would like to have about almost a half a cup of sauce per breast, so that we want about, well, I say we'll have about 2 cups. And so we want the sauce to be just thick enough so it will adhere to the breasts. So I'm going to put in about 2 tablespoons of cornstarch and then mix it up with the cream. You want to mix this all up so that there are no lumps in it. I'm using heavy cream here. When we do veal scallops, and later on, we're going to make a brown tarragon sauce, which has no cream in it. But the cream is such a French type of sauce that I wanted you to see how we did that. Now, before we add the cream, we want this to boil down. You see, it's a little bit too liquid. Take another look at our rice. Now, I want you to look. Here, you see the reason you don't stir the rice at all while it's cooking. If you notice, there are those little holes there. They look like clam holes in the sand. But you can still see that there's a little bit of liquid exuding through those holes, so the rice isn't done yet. So we cover it and let it cook some more. Now this is boiling down. What you want to do in a sauce like this, you want it to boil down until it gets a little bit syrupy. And that is a little bit syrupy now, so we take it off the heat and we put our cornstarch mixture in and stir it up to blend. And then put it back on the heat to let it cook for a few more minutes. We should see that's got a little thick now, so we thin it out with a little bit more cream, or you can use a little bouillon. But this has to cook for a minute or two to cook the cornstarch. You want to be careful at this time that you don't let the sauce scorch in the bottom of the pan. And now we want to taste it. That noise was for our rice, but we just looked at it and isn't quite ready. Now it needs a little bit of salt in it and some pepper. And then whenever you're using a sauce with cream, you may find that you need a little lemon juice in. In this case, it doesn't seem to need it. And that's still a little bit thick, so I'm going to put in a little more bouillon. And then I think we're about ready to serve it. You see, that's awfully quickly made, and it makes a simply delicious dish. Now we're ready to serve. Now the rice is here. You see there are those little clam holes. And then to make sure that it's done, you lift up an edge and tilt the pan. And if there's no liquid there, that means that you can stir it. And then you taste it to make sure that it has enough salt and pepper in. Very good. It's one of the nicest ways of making rice, and you can see it isn't difficult at all. Now I'll get rid of the herb bouquet, and then we put our rice on the platter. And then On go the chicken breasts. And see, these chicken breasts still have some of those vegetables on, and then the sauce with vegetables will go on top of that. And our sauce is all done. Now with these chicken breasts done this way, you really want to, they should be served just immediately they're cooked. After you take them out of the oven, you'd put a plate over them to keep them warm, and then your sauce really takes only about 2 minutes. And then put around a little bit of parsley, and you just have a lovely meal. I'll just put a bit of parsley right in the middle there. Parsley is certainly one of the most useful decorative things we have. And it keeps awfully well if you just wash it off and then keep it in a little jar in the refrigerator or in a covered bag. There. Now that really is an elegant meal in just a very, very few minutes. And we're serving this with hot French bread and with rice braised in stock. Next time we're going to do this, and spinach braised in stock, which is perfectly delicious. And with it we're serving a chilled white Burgundy wine. Or you can, if you'd like, serve a rosé or a chilled white Brave. Now this chicken that we used was a 3-pound fryer. And make sure when you buy your chicken breast that you get very good quality, because anything that's going to cook in 6 minutes has to be excellent quality and tender to begin with. It's really our fault as consumers if we have stringy chickens, because sometimes we're more interested in price than in quality. I got this chicken at a place that specializes in chicken, and they have perfectly beautiful beasts or birds, but you sometimes will find that the white meat of chicken is stringy, and if that's so, it's because it's probably been killed and then chilled too quickly. But if you have a bad piece of chicken, take it back to your market and complain and get all your friends to complain. That's the only way of getting good chicken. Now with the rice, I think you understood how we did that, and it is delicious with it. And next time, we're going to do vegetables the French way, including this lovely spinach. So that's all for today on The French Chef. This is Julia Child. Bon appétit.
Julia Child is co-author of the book Mastering the Art of French Cooking. French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Stores.